Hello and welcome to Learn Statistics class. In this class we are going to learn the statistical concept in simple and more easy way. The topic of today's lecture is beta first kind distribution. In this distribution we are going to learn the two points. The first point is definition of beta first kind distribution, and second point is mean and variance of beta first kind distribution. So we shall start with the definition of beta first kind. A continuous random variable x is said to follow beta first kind distribution, then its PDF is given by fx equal to 1 upon beta m n into x raised to m minus 1 minus x raised to n minus 1. Here x lies between 0 and 1 with m n positive, and the PDF is 0 otherwise, means PDF of beta first kind is 0 for the range other than 0 to 1. It is denoted as x follow beta 1 m n, with m n are parameters. Now we shall start with mean of beta first kind distribution. If x follow beta 1 with parameters m n, then mean of beta first kind distribution is defined as mean equal to expectation x, and which is equal to integration minus infinity to infinity x into fx dx. Since x is a continuous random variable, we will obtain mean with integration. As the range of x is 0 to 1, so it is 0 to 1, x PDF is 1 by beta m n, x raised to m minus 1, 1 minus x raised to n minus 1 dx. Let us take the constant outside the integration. 1 upon beta m n integration 0 to 1 x raised to m 1 minus x raised to n minus 1 dx. Here I have combined the power of x as x raised to m minus 1 plus 1, means it is x raised to m. In this topic of beta first kind distribution, to calculate the mean, variance, median, etc., we shall take the help of beta integral. So students are requested to memorize the beta integral, as I shall write it: integration 0 to 1 x raised to m minus 1 1 minus x raised to n minus 1 dx is equal to beta m n, and beta m n is equal to gamma m gamma n divided by gamma m plus n. This is the relation between beta and gamma function, which we have learned in the subject mathematics. In this topic we learn these two things on each calculation, each and every calculation. So we will compare our equation of mean, which is expectation x equal to 1 upon beta m n integration 0 to 1 x raised to m 1 minus x raised to n minus 1 dx with equation 1. We get, which is equal to beta m n into, here x raised to m and here x raised to m minus 1. So it is बीटा एम प्लस वन एंड हियर वन माइनस एक्स रेस टू एन माइनस वन इन इक्वेशन वन ऑल्सो वन माइनस एक्स रेस टू एन माइनस वन सो इट इज एन. सो वी गेट बीटा एम प्लस वन एन डिवाइडेड बाय बीटा एम एन. Now in the next step we will expand the beta with the help of beta and gamma functions. Therefore expectation of x is equal to gamma m plus 1 gamma n divided by gamma m plus n plus 1 into 1 upon gamma m gamma n divided by gamma m plus n. This gamma n get cancelled. So it is gamma m plus 1 gamma m plus n divided by gamma m plus n plus 1. Further, we know that gamma n is equal to n minus 1 gamma n minus 1. By using this result, we will expand this to gamma m plus 1 and gamma m plus n plus 1 in order to cancel gamma m and gamma m plus n. So it is m into gamma m plus n, gamma m into m plus n into gamma m plus n. We will reduce the larger gamma with the help of this reduction formula in order to cancel out the similar gammas. So gamma m and gamma m get cancelled. Similarly, gamma m plus n and gamma m plus n cancel. Therefore, the mean is equal to m by m plus n. This is the mean of beta first kind distribution with parameters m and n. Now we shall calculate the variance of beta first kind distribution. So if x follow beta 1 m n, then the variance x is defined as expectation of x square minus expectation x bracket square. We have already calculated the expectation x, so it is expectation x square minus m upon m plus n raised to 2. To obtain the value of variance, we have to obtain expectation x square. So calculate expectation x square with the formula summation integration minus infinity to infinity x square into fx dx. Since x is a continuous, we can calculate the expectation with the help of integration. As range of x is 0 to 1, so it is integration 0 to 1 x square 1 upon beta mn x raised to m minus 1 1 minus x raised to n minus 1 dx, which is equal to, let me take outside the constants, 1 upon beta mn integration 0 to 1 x raised to m plus 1 into 1 minus x raised to n minus 1 dx. This is the expected of expected value of x square, which is equal to 1 upon beta m n here we shall write the value of integration with the help of beta integral. As we know that the value of beta integral are m plus 1 plus 1 plus 1. So it is m plus 2. Further, n minus 1 plus 1. So it is n with the help of equation 1. Beta m plus 2 n divided by beta m n. By expanding this beta in the form of gamma, we get gamma m plus 2 gamma n divided by gamma m plus n plus 2 divided by gamma m gamma n upon m plus n. This gamma n get cancelled, and which is equal to expectation of x square is equal to gamma m plus 2 into gamma m plus n divided by gamma m plus n plus 2. We will expand the gamma. Here the higher gammas are m plus 2 and m plus n plus 2. Since there is plus 2 in each gamma, we will expand this gamma 2 times. So I shall expand it 2 times simultaneously in one step. How it is? So it is m plus 1 m gamma m. Each time 1 is less than the previous. So it is first time m plus 1, then m plus 1 minus 1. So it is m and gamma m. Gamma m plus n divided by gamma m. Similarly, for gamma m plus n plus 2, reduction of this gamma 2 times. So in the first step it becomes m plus n plus 1, and in the second step it is m plus n gamma m plus n. If student cannot understand this step, then please write it in two steps. Reduce the gamma by 1 in first step and further reduce it in the second step by 1. So we shall calculate gamma m, gamma m, gamma m plus m, n, gamma m plus n. So the remaining factors are m, m plus 1 divided by m plus n into m plus n plus 1. This is the value of expectation of x square. We will substitute this value in the formula of variance. Therefore, variance x is equal to m, m plus 1 divided by m plus n into m plus n plus 1 minus m square divided by m plus n square. Let me take m upon m plus n common, then it is m plus 1 divided by m plus n plus 1 minus m upon m plus n. Therefore, variance x is equal to m divided by m plus n. After taking LCM, we will get by cross multiplying m plus 1 m plus n minus m into m plus n plus 1 upon m plus n into m plus n plus 1 by multiplying the factors we get m square minus plus m n plus m plus n minus m square minus m n minus m divided by m plus n m plus n plus 1. Here m square cancel, m into n cancel, m and m cancel. So only the remaining factors are m n divided by m plus n square into m plus n plus 1. This is the value of variance of beta first kind distribution. In this way, in this lecture, we learn the definition of beta first kind, mean of beta first kind, and variance of beta first kind. And we have already derived the values of mean and variance with the help of PDF and expectation. In this way, in this lecture, we learn the beta first kind distribution. If student like this lecture, then click on the like button, share with your friends in order to learn the statistics subject in simple and more easy way, and subscribe to Learn Statistics channel for the next upcoming videos in the upcoming days. Many more topics from the statistics are taken on the Learn Statistics platform. If student want to learn all the topics, then click on the I button at the top right corner of the screen. And link of all the playlists are given in the description box. We will meet in the next lecture with the next concept. Till then, we will stop here. Thank you.